habits. Not every time, but some good habits. I always believe that the Toastmaster helps you to develop some good habit as a by default. In computer, we say that this is a setting as a by default. But in Toastmaster, what I feel, what I observe, and what I understand that it's help you to better person, better communicators, and better leadership as a by default, not a setting. I am finishing my view on this point. Let me invite presiding officer. He's very intelligent, talented, and tall Toastmaster, Toastmaster Nishant. Please welcome presiding officer, Toastmaster Nishant.
Good evening, everyone. Now, all of us have heard leaders like Larry Ellison, Steve Jobs. All of these leaders were visionaries. Now, along with being a visionary, they were also able to do what they used to say. They also transformed the technology or the world around them. But when you are a visionary and you want to transform the world, there's this essential gap that each and everyone has to follow and each and everyone should have, and that is communication. And Toastmasters, I must say, is a platform which is perfectly said where leaders are made. Toastmaster does not make a person only a leader, but along with that, they make you an efficient communicator. They groom you in such a manner that you become a leader in all aspects of your life. They make sure you're a complete package when you come out of a Toastmaster's journey. Similarly, I still remember my first meeting in December 2018, Toastmaster Sanjay was the host. And since then, I enjoyed this Toastmaster's journey. And I must say, in Toastmasters, Toastmaster Sanjay, Toastmaster Tanisha, Toastmaster Ankita, Beena ma'am, a lot of Toastmasters have helped me groom and become a better leader, a better communicator. There's no doubt in that. And similarly, they've also helped me in groom myself in all aspects of life. Let it be any leadership, delegation, or any work it comes to. All of them have helped me become a better version of myself. And that is some of the best things about Toastmasters, I must say. Now, I see we have some of the guests here. It's guest Raj. Can I get a brief introduction about you? How did you find out about Toastmasters?
Hi. Actually, I had attended the Toastmaster Banner Club. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Okay. I think a month back. After that, I think this all coronavirus thing came up and I lost track. Suddenly, I saw the message and saw that it's online. So I thought, let me join it again. So I requested Santosh to grant me the permission, and he allowed me, and that's where I am here.
We have some few visiting Toastmasters, different clubs as well. So can I get a brief introduction from some of the visiting Toastmasters? Yeah.
Yes. Hello. Am I audible?
Yeah. Yes, you are.
Hi, my name is Anushka. I am from Toastmasters Club of Pune Central. And I've just joined this. I think this is my second time attending the meeting. The first one I joined, it was during the rainy season. I don't really remember which month now. And I really liked it. So I asked Sanjay if you guys have a meeting today. And I just joined you guys. Very excited for it.
Welcome. We have guest Bala here. So can we get an introduction from you as well? Am I audible? Yeah. I think guest Bala is facing some technical issues. So we'll move on. Who we have more? Yes, we have Beena ma'am here. Yes. Hello, Beena ma'am. Yes, we have Toastmaster Ravi Sharma here. Hello, sir. Yeah, we have a lot of visiting Toastmasters. Yes, sir. Please. Yeah, do we have any other guests here? No, hi, I everyone. Think. Yeah, please.
Toastmaster Ankit. Although this is not the first time I'm attending the Baner meeting, it's always good to see the enthusiastic crowd of the members of Baner Toastmasters Club. Glad to be a part of another such meeting. Over to you, presiding officer.
Yes, thank you. We have guest Vinod here, I guess.
This is Vinod from Baner Toastmasters Club. Just I think few of the people know me from Baner Toastmasters Club, and so just trying to. Thanks.
Yeah, we have guests. Yes. Yeah. She's muted. Yeah. So I think now it's time to invite our Toastmaster of the day. She's one of the most dynamic Toastmasters, of the best speakers I've seen on stage. And she's my mentor too, and who has always mentored me throughout my Toastmasters journey. So with a big round of applause, please welcome Toastmaster Tanisha on stage as TMOD for today's meeting.
Thank you so much for that introduction, Toastmaster Nishant. It was a pleasure to hear that introduction from you. So, good evening, Toastmasters and guests. The presiding officer, fellow Toastmasters, all the visiting Toastmasters and guests, I welcome you all to another exciting program of fun and learning in which we have this third online meeting and 198th chapter meeting of Baner Toastmasters Club. So today, I am Tanisha Singh, your host for today's meeting. So since we are seeing many changes nowadays because of the situation we all know, and we have many new members and visiting guests, so I thought of to tell everyone more about Toastmasters. And then when we are having online meetings, we have a lot of guests also joining in. So not only guests or other members, but I guarantee that each and every one of us present today, we will know more about Toastmasters today. And I have a quiz also. So I'll be asking questions, and the person who answers maximum correct answers would be declared the winner at the end of today's meeting. So before anything, I would like to tell that Toastmasters International is a non-profit educational organization that teaches public speaking and leadership skills throughout the world, and it has a worldwide network of clubs. The organization membership exceeds to 3,58,000 members, and in across 143 countries, we have more than 16,800 clubs. We have approximately 85 clubs in Pune itself, with 16,000 members in Pune. So now here I have a question. Since I have told you a little bit about Toastmasters, I want to test how much you know about Toastmasters. So to answer this, this is fastest finger first. So you can type in your answers and send in to me, to Baner Toastmasters Club chat, and give your answers. So the first answer which is received, the first correct answer will get the marks, and I'll be jotting down the points here. So the question is, in which year Toastmasters International was started and by whom? So you have 15 seconds to type in your answers and send me the year in which Toastmasters International was started and by whom. Okay, so I see a lot of answers coming in, and it feels happy to see that many of you know the answers. So moving on, I'll explain the agenda for today's meeting. So there is a slight change in agenda. The timer for today is mentioned as Neha. So the timer has changed to Parijat Garg. So today's timer is Parijat Garg. Everything else remains same as in the agenda. Coming to the two sections of today's meeting, the first half will consist of prepared speeches. Today we have three speakers. Two speakers would be speaking in the starting section, and one speaker would be speaking at last, followed by impromptu speaking in table topic section for Toastmasters and guests. The second half will be for evaluation for prepared speeches, role player reports, and moments of glory. We will have one speech after the general evaluator's report is finished from manual special occasion speeches presenting an award. The changes are already mentioned. So now let me introduce to you my fellow colleagues who will help me in control and conduct of today's meeting. So we have someone who opened the meeting with a lot of energy. He is a digital marketing manager who likes reading books and watching web series. So let us all applaud for Toastmaster Santosh, the Sergeant at Arms, for today's meeting. Next up, to give us critical feedback of the language that we use, we have a student in pharmaceutical management who likes talking to new people and knowing about different culture. She will also introduce the word of the day and phrase of the day for today's meeting. So I request Toastmaster Rutuja to speak.
Good evening, Presiding Officer, fellow Toastmasters and guests. My job as a grammarian is to introduce to you all about the word of the day and phrase of the day. So I'll introduce the word of the day, which is flamboyant. Flamboyant means to attract attention because of confidence and style. One usage is, we have had some fairly flamboyant speeches about end of the local government. The phrase of the day is talk a blue streak. To talk a blue streak means to talk very rapidly and continuously with a stream of words. So a proper usage of this could be, she is generally quiet, but she talks a blue streak when we ask her about fashion. I urge all the Toastmasters and speakers who ever come on stage to use the word of the day and the phrase of the day. Thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Rutuja. So to keep track of time, we have someone who makes amazing posters for our club, and he is a consistent Toastmaster who tries to attend every meeting, and we can see how diligent he is in his work. So let us welcome Toastmaster Parijat as the timer.
Good evening, everyone.
Good evening.
I am Parijat. I am the timer for today's meeting. My job today is to keep track of time for every flamboyant speech that our brilliant speakers deliver today, whether as prepared or table topic or any other content they talk about. I will report the timing when I'm called upon. The timing sequence is, the green card will be shown whenever the minimum time for the speech is met. I'll show the amber card whenever the middle point of the speech qualification is met. And I'll show the card whenever the end point of the timing sequence is met. 30 second grace is given, and after that I will play out a buzzer, a sound from my mobile phone, and I will be sharing my screen on which you will see the colors, so it will be something of this nature. I hope you can see this. So this will give the speakers a sense of the timing. So this is how I will move during my role. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you, Parijat. So next up, we have someone who will act as an hour counter for today's meeting. She is a product manager at Cummins, who loves to paint and likes exploring blogging professionally. So I asked her what she wants to change in Toastmasters. She said she would like people to be more accepting of critical, honest feedback and really taking it positively to change one's personal development. So please welcome the expression queen of BTMC, Toastmaster Ankita.
Thank you, Toastmaster Tanisha, for that wonderful introduction. Good evening, everyone. Good evening to the presiding officer, Toastmaster of the day, and fellow Toastmasters and lovely guests. My name is Ankita Gupta, and I am your R counter for the day. My duty as an R counter is to listen to every speaker, everybody who comes, gets the limelight and comes on stage, listen to them attentively and make a note of a few things. The top three things that I will be making a note of, the crutch sounds, for example, filler words, but so like, well, filler phrases, you know, and so, etc. And when I will be called upon, I will give a report of these speaking errors. Thank you so much. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Ankita. So someone else will be observing every single thing that will happen throughout the meeting. Later, that person will take us through evaluation section and give us feedback about the proceedings, the environment, and general comments. To act as general evaluator, we have Toastmaster Nisarg Mehta. So before moving to the speakers and the speeches today, let me tell you all about the structure of Toastmasters governance. Like we have cities, then states, country, continent, and so on. So in Toastmasters, the smallest unit is a club. And 4 or 5 clubs together make an area. Like our Baner club belongs to area C3, with Sanjay being the area director. 4 or 5 clubs together comprise a division. Our division C has 4 areas with Toastmaster Harshad serving as our division director. So here I come up with next question. So be ready, as this is fastest finger first. So type in your answer and send in personal chat to Baner Toastmasters Club. The question is, tell the names of all the divisions of Pune along with the division director names. All the 4 divisions of Pune with the name of division directors. So only the first name of division directors would suffice.
Tanisha, I guess I, Sanjay, and Ravi should be out of this activity.
Yeah, you would be knowing every answer. So thank you for the suggestion, Ankit. So our DPPRM Ravi and the area director Sanjay and Ankit are out of this quiz because you will be knowing all the answers. So this is for... So when you have passed...
I sent the answers, I take them back. I sent you the answers, I take them back.
Anyways, I knew the answers. I'm not going to show them to anyone. So thank you for the suggestion, Ankit. So I can see I have received so many answers already. So with this, one small thing is the divisions come together and form a district. So ours is District 98, which is spread across 6 Indian states of Gujarat, Madhya Pradesh, Maharashtra, Chhattisgarh, Telangana, and Andhra Pradesh. So district form a region with us coming in Region 13, and then we have the international headquarters. So we start from clubs, then area, division, district, region, and then so on. Next, we will learn more, but now without boring you all, let us begin with first section of prepared speeches. So each project in Pathways has a specific time limit and certain fixed objective. That's why we call it as a project. So each project teaches us some aspect of public speaking, such as body language, vocal variety, persuasive skill, etc. The speakers will try to learn various such aspects in their speeches. So the first speaker today will attempt his level 2 project 1 from dynamic leadership path of Pathways. The evaluator for this speech is Toastmaster Nancy. I request Toastmaster Nancy to read out the objectives of the speech.
So good evening, everyone. I'm Nancy Jain, and I'm evaluating the speech of Toastmaster Jitin. So the purpose of this project is for the member to identify his primary leadership style. And the purpose of the speech is for the member to share some aspect of his primary leadership style and discuss leadership styles in general. So the project title is My Leadership Aspects, and so let's hear about this more from Toastmaster Jitin. So good luck, Toastmaster Jitin.
Thank you, Toastmaster Nancy. Timer, please note, the time allowed is 5 to 7 minutes, meaning the lightning sequence is green at 5 minutes, yellow at 6 minutes, and red at 7, and the buzzer to be shown at 7.5 minutes. So the speaker is a mechanical engineer who loves traveling and playing football. One thing which he likes about Toastmaster is competitiveness, which brings in best of people. So let us welcome Toastmaster Jitin. Toastmaster Jitin, my leadership aspects, Toastmaster Jitin.
A leader is one who knows the way, goes the way, and shows the way. A great quote by John C. Maxwell. We all are leaders in some way or other. There is a leader in each and every one of us. Right from my childhood days, I saw a captain steering our ship amidst all fortunes and crises. He taught me the virtues of negotiation and risk-taking throughout his lifetime. My dearest father, who is no more with me. When my father was sick and the family was struggling due to various reasons, I saw a new captain in the ship who taught me the virtues of dedication and self-respect. My very loving mother. A warm good evening to all Toastmasters, future Toasters, dear guests. My style of leadership, as indicated by Toastmasters pathway, is affiliative leadership style. To be frank, first thing I had to do after getting the survey results was to go to Google and type to understand the meaning of affiliative leadership. An affiliative leader is someone who fosters connection with the team members and motivates them with praise and recognition. This leader's objective is to create a cohesive unit by emphasizing teamwork and harmony. I deeply believe that these traces of affiliative leadership were not built into my genes when I was born. There are a lot of situations and people who influence our personality, and hence our leadership pattern gets evolved day by day. I could remember the small leadership roles like being the class monitor and house captain in the schools, leading photography college in my college, taking lead in planning trips at various occasions, and also leading the CSR activities in my company. Anything and everything had contributed in somehow to my leadership aspects. Affiliative leadership also calls for being humble and showing the flexibility as the situation demands. In certain situations, I had seen many of the leaders stepping down from the leadership roles and contributing as a team member when they believe that someone else can perform it better than what they can. But the point to be noted is that only a confident and a leader who have enough faith in their team can perform this task. I hope most of us already know about Indira Nooyi, who was the first woman CEO of PepsiCo. Personally, she is one of my favorite leaders as well. I would like to reflect the incident that happened with Indira on the night she was named as the president of PepsiCo in 2001. She was so happy and proud that she rushed to her home to share the good news where she saw her mother. "I have got great news for you," she shouted. Her mother replied, "It can wait. We need you to go out and get some milk for us." Nooyi was so disappointed, but she still went out and got milk for her family. She was absolutely mad and disappointed that she came back and shouted at her mother, "I had great news for you. I had just been named the president of PepsiCo, and all you wanted me to do is just go out and get some milk." Her mother gave back her classic reply, "Let me explain something to you, dear. You may be the president of PepsiCo, but when you step into this house, you are a wife and a mother first. Nobody can take that place in our family. So leave that crown in the carriage." knew you were sharing this story as part of the lessons learned. After completing 10 years of running this $166 billion company. Many people are born as leaders, but many leaders are created by virtue of their situations and attitudes towards their life. I was talking to my sister last week, who is working as a nurse in London. Even though the entire world is locked down with the terror of coronavirus, she travels 3 hours a day to go to her hospital and completes her 9-hour shift. When we all engineers and all white-collared people are locked inside rooms with the cosiness of work from home, new leaders are born in the society to take control of the situation. For me, everyone in the medical field is a leader, whether it be doctors, nurses, hospital staff, the cleaners, pharmacists, and even the ambulance drivers. They are the leaders of the moment who are showing to us, showing to the world, they can lead this world to conquer COVID-19 pandemic. So, dedicating my thoughts and well wishes to the leaders of the moment, all the medical professionals, as well as all other leaders, for your selfless service to this world, I conclude wishing you a wonderful evening. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you, Jitin. So let us pause for 30 seconds to write feedback for the speaker. So I would request everyone to write feedback and send it personally only to Jitin, as he was the speaker, and not to everyone. So you can write your feedback and send it to Jitin. So there's a small correction which I told you all about the division and the area. So our division has 5 areas and not 4 areas. Another area is added. So now division C has 5 areas. So we heard Jitin giving his level 2 speech of Pathways. So Pathways in Toastmasters, it is the education program of Toastmasters. It has special, it has 11 learning paths to choose from. Once you have taken your online assessment, which helps us to decide which path is right for us. If you are a student, if you are a working professional, if you are an entrepreneur. So it helps you to assess what path you should choose. To assess Pathways, you need to go to Basecamp. And Basecamp is your online gateway to Pathways, where you will find everything you need on your journey in Toastmasters. And with this information, I have another question. And to all who are confused, I am logged in as Baner Toastmasters Club. So you don't have to look for Tanisha to send in your answers. You have to look for Baner Toastmasters Club to send in your answers. So I'll be asking you the next question, and you can type in your answers in chat and send in to Baner Toastmasters Club. So the question related to Pathways is, which is the newly added path in Pathways learning program? The latest newly added path among all those 11 paths in Pathways learning program. So I can see a lot of answers coming in. We have too many fastest fingers here. So moving on, we have our second speaker who is attempting his 5th speech of ACG, the abstract concept, from speaking to informal manual. The evaluator for this speech is Toastmaster Sanjay. I request Toastmaster Sanjay to read out the objectives of the speech.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Tanisha. Toastmaster Sharma will be attempting his ECG-5 from the Speaking to Inform manual, and this project is titled The Abstract Concept. The purpose of this talk is for the speaker to present a 6 to 8 minute analysis of a concept, idea, theory, historical force, or social political issue. The talk should be clear and interesting to the audience. The speaker's purpose is to clearly explain the meaning of the subject to the audience, and the use of definitions, examples, anecdotes, illustrations, quotes from experts, and visual aids to explain concepts. The objectives, in short, again, are research and analyze an abstract concept, theory, historical force, or social political issue. Present the ideas in a clear and interesting manner. Timer, please note, the time is 6 to 8 minutes. All the best, Ravi.
Thank you, Toastmaster Sanjay. Timing as informed, 6 to 8 minutes, which means green at 6 minutes, yellow at 7 minutes, red at 8 minutes, and the buzzer will be shown at 8.5 minutes. So the speaker is an investment banker who has recently developed a hobby of cooking just 3 days back as a consequence of lockdown, I presume. So one thing he likes about Toastmasters is it gives us opportunity one after the other. Everyone has something or the other to learn or benefit from it. And when I asked what he wants to change in Toastmasters, he says, sometimes we start losing genuineness. We need to be more of what we are and care less about our image. That will help us keep moving on the learning curve. And I totally agree with this. So let us welcome Toastmaster Ravi to deliver his speech. Toastmaster Ravi, the Overton window. The Overton window, Toastmaster Ravi.
Thank you, Toastmaster of the day. Fellow Toastmasters and dear guests. I have a question for all of you. And if you believe the answer to this question is a yes, I would request you to please raise your hand. Now the question is, how many of you believe that in the next 2 years, India will take back Pakistan-occupied Kashmir? I don't see a single hand raised. All right. My second question to you is, how many of you feel that in the next 3 years, India will be tagged, labeled constitutionally as a Hindu nation? Let me just check the hands again. No one is raising the hand. Okay. So you believe that India is not going to do what our politicians keep on talking. We will take Pakistan-occupied Kashmir. We should make India a Hindu nation. Well, before you start thinking, this is not a political speech. This has got nothing to do with religion, Hindu or Muslim. This has got to do something with a very interesting concept in political science. Being a student of political science, I love this concept a lot. And the concept, as the Toastmaster today mentioned, is the Overton window. Now, what is the Overton window? The Overton window is the policy which says that any policy, any idea, any thought should have a range of policies, should have a range of possibilities to which the mainstream population can think and can react upon. So who invented this, the Overton window theory? This theory was invented by Mr. Joseph Overton, on whose surname this theory got named. And Mr. Overton, on one of the fine days for his trust, wanted to raise some money and wanted to talk about the government policies for education. So he came up with a brochure where he mentioned the two extreme sides of what the government could do in the field of education. So he said, fine. There would be least government intervention on one hand, which means there would be zero investment by the government in the education of the masses. And the rare extreme was that there will be extreme involvement of the government, which would mean everyone would be forced to join compulsorily government colleges. Now, do you think this is possible in a normal given scenario? Of course not. These are the two extremes which is not practical, which is not possible to happen, because no individual, no citizen would buy into such arguments. And that is what exactly the Overton concept speaks about. It says, whenever someone comes up with a policy, with the idea, and you want people to approve it, political parties wanting to approve an idea from the people, it is important that you prove and you provide them with the most extreme ideas, so that even if they do not agree with your most extreme thoughts, they would just come a filter down and agree to something which they actually want. Let's take a couple of examples. Bernie Sanders in 2015 wanted Medicare for all in the United States. And that time he had no support. When he put the legislation later in 2017, he had 17 supporters, going to 40 supporters to 150 supporters, as quoted by the New York Times. The message is clear. An idea that looks unconventional, unacceptable at a given point in time, becomes very normal a few years later. I never thought 3 years back that something as critical and sensitive as an Article 370, which was a special status to the state of Jammu and Kashmir, could be revoked in our country, which has so many religions, so many sects, so many political parties, so many ideologies. How can this happen? This is completely not possible. There would be a lot of violence across the country. But here we are. Article 370 gets revoked. Unimaginable stuff gets achieved. So the theory says that the window has five parameters to it. It says start with the policy. It goes on to become a popular policy, which is sensible, which is acceptable, which becomes very radical and unthinkable. When Donald Trump came into his presidency campaign, he spoke about how he would curb down Mexico from infiltrating more with drugs into his country. He spoke about how he would stop immigration, especially for the Asian countries, so that his countrymen get more jobs. Now, at that point in time, I personally thought this is not possible. The United States is dependent on all the laborers from outside for their country. But a thing that looked impossible at that point in time became possible. In India, without naming the political parties, the parties these days are taking up one issue to an extreme. They would want to achieve a state of mind, a state of action, a state of the state, basically. For example, a certain kind of nation. But however, it is very important for them to understand that they can't achieve this point. So they become happy when even people start accepting this. Now, here's an example of my friend, by the way, leaving political parties aside. My friend was dating a Christian girl, and my friend happens to be Hindu. His parents were not agreeing to his marriage with a Christian girl. So he said, what should I do? He went on to studies abroad. And then later on, he called up his mother and said, hey, I have fallen in love with a German. And I'm going to marry this German girl now. I am really in love with her. Now, parents back in India, they're really tensed. And what actually happened to the friend was, his mother said, no. That German is not required. What about that Christian girl? And that was a hoax which he played with his parents. The Overton concept even comes to place here. You bring people to an idea that becomes unacceptable to them, unthinkable, so that they accept something which is at least little below that. The same thing has been going across India too. Now, we can also talk about gay marriages. If you talk about gay marriages in India, it may become a little difficult to be acceptable. But you talk about gay marriages, people at least come down to accepting gay rights, accepting gays and lesbians. You go on to talk about animals should be also given human rights now. And people would be perplexed. What is he talking about? Animals being given human rights? At least people who are concerned with animals can go on to speak that provide them the rights that they deserve as animals. So people would start accepting a little bit less. In conclusion, the Overton concept tells that you need to ring the bell noisily on what you want to achieve. You want to aggravate the situation a little more so that people who need to accept it, at least in the form that you will be comfortable with. 3 days back, a legislation has been introduced in the United States of having a digital currency of dollar. We don't know if this is possible, but let's see if the Overton concept works for that.
Thank you, Toastmaster Ravi. So let us pause for 30 seconds to write the feedback for the speaker. Kindly write your feedback on the chat and send it personally to Toastmaster Ravi and not to everyone. So now, since we all know that we are part of District 98. So like in clubs, we have executive committee comprising of 7 members. We have president, then VP education, VP membership, and so on. So in district also, we have top 7 officials. So to let you all know about these 7 officials, I'll share my screen so that you don't only know the names, but you have a face to that, to those names. So let me know once you're able to see my screen. Can anyone say if my screen is visible?
Yes,
it's visible.
Okay, thank you. So this now I'll be showing you the top 7 officials of District 98. So we have our district director, Toastmaster Venkata. And this is Toastmaster Mukta Natkar, who is the Program Quality Director of our District 98. Then we have Dipankar Das, the Club Growth Director of our district. Toastmaster Aaron is the District Administrator Manager. Toastmaster Revati is the District Finance Manager. And we already heard our DP RM, District Public Relations Manager, who is with us and waving hands at us, Toastmaster Ravi Sharma.
Thank you.
And we have Ravi Teja, who was the immediate past District Director of District 98. So these are the top 7 district officials of District 98. So now we are done with the speakers to prepare speeches of today's evening. So I'll ask the timer to tell us whether the speakers have qualified or not and give us the exact timings of these 2 speeches. Toastmaster Parija.
Hi. So Toastmaster Jitin, his time was 5 minutes 39 seconds. And Toastmaster Ravi, his time was 10 minutes 8 seconds. So as per the timing qualification, only Toastmaster Jitin qualifies.
Okay. So, Sanjay, you are saying something. You are not unmute. Okay.
Nothing. Nothing at all.
Okay. So we were about to share a Google form for the voting, which is not required. So that would be shared later by Toastmaster Santosh in the next voting section. So next part of today's meeting is to test our ability to think fast and speak impromptu in the table topic section. So the table topic master is a technical leader in Cummins who likes tracking. One thing which he likes about Toastmasters is learning from everyone other's experience. So let us welcome the table topic master for today's evening, Toastmaster Vinod.
Thank you, Toastmaster Tanisha. Presiding officer, Toastmaster Uday, fellow Toastmasters, and dear guest. I'm Toastmaster Vinod. Your table topic master for today's meeting. So, you know, Toastmaster, we have two parts of impromptu speaking session. The first one is the round robin session where we get a chance to speak for 15 seconds each. And second is the table topic where you would get chance to speak for 1 to 2 minutes. So how the table topics help Toastmaster to improve the skills? So attempting impromptu speaking help us to produce the art of improvisation and also help us think on our feet. This also help us to develop the 4 vital communication skills, and those skills are listening, thinking, organizing, and delivery. I urge every speaker to use the word of the day and the timing sequence for the round robin is 15 seconds. Our timer will press the buzzer or show the card. After the 15 seconds, the speaker has to stop and the next speaker will also will start speaking. Okay, so are we ready for the round robin? I will take the person name and that person will speak for 15 seconds. So today, how we'll proceed for the Robin round is, I have one incident to share with you and you have to imagine in that incident, you have to continue that story, how you will come out of the incidents. Parizad, are we ready as timer? Okay, all right. Yeah, so let me start with the incident. I'll start the story. So one day, I and Amit was traveling in a flight for the customer visit. The pilot suddenly announced that there is a trouble in the engine of the flight. And the pilot asked all passengers to take the parachute and jump out of the flight. The one issue was that there were the parachutes were very limited.
Okay. I'm not sure.
Okay, so I'll take. Yeah. Next speaker is Ankita.
So the parachutes were limited, and then hell broke loose because we started fighting with each other, and it wasn't a flamboyant conversation that we had. Everybody was cursing one another and just fighting with each other to get hold. And finally, I got hold of Amit's parachute because I was also there. And I didn't really care much for him. Yeah.
Vaibhav.
Okay. So in this story, hello, I'm audible?
Yeah.
Hello?
Yes.
So in this story,
yeah,
how come Ankita?
Yes.
How come Ankita game? I don't know, because you both were there. So continuing with that only, so there were limited parachutes. So you both somehow managed to get one parachute, and then both were fighting with each other that who will jump with this parachute. And finally, you told a story to Toastmaster Amit that what a cruel world it is. You know, everywhere there is coronavirus spread and all. Anyhow,
Amit Chakravarti.
Now, since the fight was with me, but I being a flamboyant guy, I had a very new technology where I could use wings and fly, and thus I donated all my parachutes. I gave even to Ankita and Vinod also. So Anil. I used my wings to fly.
Toastmaster Anil.
Yeah, so this is such a coincidence that you were talking about parachute, and somebody's thinking of taking a parachute, moving it, you know, dipping it into alcohol or some other chemicals which will make it like a mask. And when the whole world is struggling with coronavirus, people are thinking, well, how do you convert all this parachute into mask and protect yourself from the deadly virus?
Toastmaster Ankit.
Yes, talking about the deadly virus, it is a struggle. And rather than fighting with the virus, we actually had to fight within ourselves, and I had to jump effectively. It was just pulling each other's leg, but along with the parachute, which is now oiled. But what else could have been done? Over to you, Vinod.
Toastmaster Anushka.
Everyone is talking about getting from this flight via parachute, and I can only remember my time when this happened. It was during paragliding. That was the only time I can remember getting out of it, and I just do not want to remember that because it was not a good incident at all for me. I was really little.
Beena ma'am.
Parachute, we've come to paragliding, and I have got a very good experience of paragliding in Bangkok when I went, and I reached to the top and I was watching all around, and it was as if I had met God. It was so beautiful to watch the entire scenery from a different perspective that it just blew me off. It was flamboyant, the whole scenery. Thank you.
Master Vilas.
Yeah, I'm coming. I'm on my way.
Master Vilas.
I'm coming.
We can proceed, Vinod. Let's proceed.
Yeah. Toastmaster Sanjay. Toastmaster Sanjay. All right.
What a fantastic way when I wish I get the parachute also this way. When I ask and when I try to open my mouth and the people say, here you go, you've spoken, here you go with the parachute. And that's exactly, you know, it's a great feeling to get the parachute that way. Even if I don't get the parachute, I'll make sure I crack some jokes. Some people will laugh, some people won't. I'll ensure that I crack some pathetic jokes. So some people just fall asleep and I get the parachute from them, the limited ones.
Toastmaster.
Yeah. So everyone's talking about coronavirus, but people followed the boil back in the plane. And they were Toastmaster Sanjay and Toastmaster Vatsal. How would they get out? It was quite simple. Toastmaster Sanjay had his bike there. He said, we'll make a stunt like Fast and Furious and jump on from the bike. The Toastmaster Sanjay and Toastmaster Vatsal sat on the bike and just jumped off the plane on that bike itself. It was quite flamboyant to see that.
Ketki. Do we have Ketki online?
Ketki isn't on the call.
Okay. Manu.
Manu is
on the call. Manu.
Manu isn't on the call.
Okay. Toastmaster Nancy.
So I started looking everywhere, and I approached to one slim and lightweighted girl, and I bribed her that if she could share her parachute, I will enroll her in a gym for 1 year membership for free, and she agreed, and I could save my life.
Okay. We have Pushpa online. Okay, Narayanan.
As there were very, very limited parachutes, the members of the flight are fighting for their parachutes and no one is getting it, and people are creating a panic over there, and most of them are youngsters, and they are they want to somehow get out of the flight safely. So everyone is trying to get their parachutes, which is not happening.
Neha, Toastmaster Neha.
As all said, parachutes were limited, and all of them want jump out of plane. So I'll crack joke like Sanjay said. I also crack lame joke. So I'll get all parachutes from cockpit and jump out from plane.
Toastmaster Nishant.
Personal hasn't happened yet.
We have Toastmaster Nishant.
No, I'm done. I've done my round robin.
Okay. Raj Jagtap.
Yeah, I being the host in that plane, I just asked them to calm down, and finally we counted that there was an extra box where a lot of parachutes were there. While I was allocating the parachutes, the pilot informed that the problem has been restored and people need not jump now. So I accordingly closed the door.
Ravi Sharma. Do we have Ravi Sharma? Okay.
Ravi, you're on mute.
Lutuja.
Yeah, so as everyone is saying, there were only limited parachutes, and I saw Toastmaster Sanjay, Toastmaster Tanisha, and Toastmaster Ankita fighting for that. Toastmaster Amit had left the plane in a flamboyant manner. So then I had to save myself. So these guys were talking in blue streak. So then what did I do? I closed the door of that plane, and I didn't let anybody go out of it, because if I die, everyone has to die. So that's what I did. Thank you.
Toastmaster Santosh.
I started from when Toastmaster Sanjay and Vatsar jumped from the plane with the bike, and unfortunately they landed in a Pune, and immediately policeman said, "Kare, you are roaming in the city and in the lockdown," and this is something very surprise situation for both Sanjay and Vatsal, and they got to know that it's better they should in a plane, because in land there is a dangerous virus, coronavirus, and everyone inside the home. So
Toastmaster Jitin.
As there was shortage for the parachutes, and many of the mechanical engineers in town like Sanjay had given up on the situation, I thought it's my opportunity to step up and help the people by trying to create a parachute of my own. So the immediate step for me was to collect all the umbrellas inside. I got few umbrellas from the girls inside the flight, like Ankita, Tanisha, Rutuja, and we tied it up together, and we looked for the strings and the bells which can make up the situation. Again, as it went on, the final parachute was in place.
Toastmaster Parijat.
Toastmaster Parijat.
It's me. Yeah. Hi. So I have not been hearing the story. So I think I was still struggling to do the timer's role here, the new format, and I just heard some parachute and some jumping. So my is up.
Okay. Toastmaster Vinod. Toastmaster Vinod Basalali.
Vinod isn't on the call.
Vinod is not here.
Okay. Toastmaster Tanisha.
Okay, so as Nishant was very flamboyant about Sanjay and Vatsal riding the bike and jumping on to catch it, but I thought to use my skills and I started talking blue streak and I was trying to woo so that I get the parachute and I am saved from not falling down. And then suddenly I saw my mentor Toastmaster Ankita flying on her own wings in the sky. So I was so motivated that I was like, okay, this is what I also want to do. Was
okay. And do you have another Neha? I was seeing two Neha. Arjun?
No, we don't have Arjun.
Do you have Arjun on? Okay. Do you have Amardeep?
No, Aman is
Amandeep, left. Sorry.
Aman is left.
Vilas? Toastmaster Vilas?
Vilas isn't here. I think Anusha, Raju and Vatsal, three of them haven't spoken. Okay. Okay, Anusha and Raju have left the moment I called out their names.
Vatsal. My bad.
Okay. Vatsal?
So me and Sanjay were on a bike and we were going so fast and I was just, you know, recalling all of our times, and then I was like, everything is going so fast and this virus is there, and we were just discussing how awesome his bike is, the entire ghost town, the police guy who we just actually, you know, evaded, and how flamboyantly we were all just trying to fight here and there, and you know, we just forgot about how to actually just figure out stuff slowly and steadily. But it's okay, a bike ride on a ghost town of Pune, so what else do you need? And everything up there is, everyone up there is trying to fight with parachutes and just fall down.
Anybody else is not spoke, can take voluntarily. If I miss anyone's name.
I guess we are done.
All right. I think, is that fantastic thoughts? Imagine if you are in the flight and don't have parachute and pilot asks to jump down. Well done. We have claps for everyone. All right. Are we taking break for 5 minutes, Tanisha? Before going to table topics, Master?
Yeah, we can take table 3 minutes of break.
All right. Okay. So we'll take 3 minute break and come back for the another session. Timer Parijat, can you set a clock? Thank you.
Aur Vitsal, kya haal hai? Good to see you.
Oh my God. Man, my heart was
UK se live, joining in live from UK.
Hey, what's up?
Hi Sanjay. Hi.
Thank you, buddy. Long time, man.
It's been so long. It's been so goddamn long. My heart was beating before I came over here. I was like, I'm not gonna be entering from the class or peeping inside if you know anyone's giving a speech and stuff.
Oh, I remember the times you had to rush after your exams. You know, entering the room, chanting. Tough times.
He was like, the late Vatsal, remember?
Exactly.
Today also, and I joined again late. Today also he was late. See, he's continuing that.
Tanisha, some you have to maintain.
मेरे वत्सल भैया को कोई कुछ नहीं बोलेगा. मेरे वत्सल भैया को कुछ नहीं बोलेगा.
Not this भैया thing again.
Eiffel Tower.
So a lot of new members for people who are thinking what the conversation is. Vatsal is one of our good old members.
He's the oldest of us all.
Yeah. And that's the reason Nishant calls him Vatsal Bhaiya.
Vatsal Bhaiya, my God, my God.
Is it a break? Hello?
Yes, this is a
break. Yes, Vaibhav, it is a break.
1 minute.
Achha, Vaibhav bhi hai. Kya haal hai, Vaibhav? Tum toh chai
bhi hai. Hi. Kya? Nahi, Maggie kha raha tha.
No, nothing to do like that during meeting.
We know, we all know.
More than Maggie now. God.
एडिटिंग की वो सब देख रहा है लोग मतलब
अरे तो तुमने अपनी वीडियो दिखा रखी है तो सब देखेंगे ही ना तुम्हें
हां मैं तो केवल स्पीकर को देख रहा था तो
he was giving him giving us the Durga Cafe feels fellowship feels
oh Durga Cafe
चलो good to see you guys
निसर you can
अमित बाबा कहां है अमित बाबा अपने छुपे हुए हैं
अच्छा
पेंटिंग द येलो कर्टन योर स्पीकर योर हेडसेट सब दिखेंगे अच्छे से
ओके 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 ओके
नो व्हाट ही इज आस्किंग कि व्हाट विल ही बी एबल टू सी इफ ही इज द स्पीकर एंड
ही इज डेमोंस्ट्रेट ना वी डोंट लाइक स्पॉटलाइट ऑन यू
सपोज यू आर स्पीकिंग ना स्पॉटलाइट इज ऑन यू अंकिता सो व्हाट आर यू एबल टू सी ऑन योर स्क्रीन दैट इज माय क्वेश्चन
So Vaibhav, there is an option you can see yourself as the speaker view or probably as a gallery view. You can see the entire audience also.
Nisha timer.
Yeah.
So where is that option?
If you are logged in from your mobile, you'll not get that option. Log in from the desktop or a laptop.
Okay. So timer. Okay.
That's why I can't see anybody when I'm seeing okay, when I'm you. Talking.
Correct.
Yes.
Okay.
So we can start with our table topic session now. Sorry, everyone. We'll catch up again after the meeting as a fellowship.
Okay. Sure.
So I request the table topic master to, yeah, you know this here.
All right. So welcome back, guys. Good evening,
guys. Vinod, your voice is low.
Second session.
Vinod, your voice is very feeble. Can you adjust your earphone, headphone? We are hardly able to hear you.
Can you hear me now?
No.
How about now?
Yeah. Perfect.
Hello?
Yes,
yeah. Okay. Actually, I was using the... Okay, all right. So welcome back again. So we'll proceed for the next session of our table topic. I'll call upon some of the Toastmaster and our guest to speak on the topic. Okay. So timing sequence is 1 minute is a green, yellow is 1 minute 30 second, and red is 2 minute, and buzzer at 2 minute 30 second. Okay. So first table topic I would like to call our guest Anushka. Anushka, can you hear me?
Yes, I can hear you. Can you hear me?
Okay. Yes. Okay. So Anushka, topic is Jack of all trades. And master of none, jack of all trades and master of none. Anushka.
Yes, thank you so much for the topic. And trades and master of none. To be honest, I have been there when it feels like your friends, your cousins are so good at studying. At playing some game, any sport or any hobby, and you feel like they have it all sorted and you don't. you just don't know anything what to do. It was 2 years ago when I was fed up of not being able to find the things, to find the activities what I like. So I started experimenting with different activities. I went to a dance class. I didn't like it that much, so I switched it. I changed it to a drums class, a musical class. I didn't like that either. So I changed it to some other class about the handwriting, the calligraphy class. I didn't like that either. And finally, I changed it to public speaking club, which is none other than Art Toastmasters. Now, with this all experience, I've learned it is that I could have handled the dance, the singing, the music, the handwriting, as well as public speaking. But it could have just been, I could have been mediocre at all of these things. I don't believe in multitasking. I believe that if I'm good at one thing, if I'm truly passionate about it, the next step is to get better at that and keep on keeping on, keep on pushing those imaginary boundaries and imaginary limits that I had. And when it comes to Toastmasters, I finally found what I truly liked. I went on to giving the evaluation contest. I won the evaluation contest. I won the area level. And I, for the first time, straight for the first time, I even represented my area in the division. So I truly believe that, yes, jack of all trade, you don't need to be. You definitely can be the master of one. And to always keep on improving, always keep on pushing, that is what my philosophy is. Thank you so much for the topic and thank you for letting me speak. Over to you, Table Topic Master.
Thank you, Anishka.
Thank you.
Okay. So pause for a couple of seconds to give the feedback. Are we giving feedback in Table Topic? Okay. So next, speaker for Table Topic, I would like to call Toastmaster Vaibhav. Toastmaster Vaibhav, can you hear me?
Hello? Yes?
Yeah. Toastmaster Vaibhav, curiosity killed the cat. Curiosity killed the cat. Toastmaster Vaibhav.
Okay, so presiding officer, Toastmaster of the day, fellow Toastmasters, and my dear guests, good evening.
Good evening.
So my topic is curiosity kills the cat. No, but I partially agree with this topic because as the topic suggests, if you're doing something, if you're too curious about the thing, you won't be able to give your 100% to it because for each and every step, you'll be asking why, how, and why are you taking that step? And you know, whether you are giving it your 100% and whether you are going on the right track. But I believe that there should be a curiosity. There should be a, you know, minimal amount of everything. You know, if you cook a dish, you cannot just go with a single thing. If you are, cooking a butter chicken, you cannot just go with chicken in it. You need some spices, butter, everything. So before doing every work, you should have little curiosity about that thing. Curiosity that whether you like it or not. Curiosity that whether you will be able to do it or not. Curiosity that what that work really is. So life is a mixture of everything. So yes, whenever you do anything, there should be a little pinch of curiosity in it also. That's all. Thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Vaibhav. Okay, so third topic, I would like to call Vinod. Do we have Vinod online?
No, Vinod's not there.
Okay. Okay. So third topic, I would like to call Neha. Neha, can you hear me? Neha Bhange?
Yes, yes, yes.
Okay. So Neha,
if you had to teach something, what you would teach? If you had to teach something, what you would teach? Toastmaster Neha.
Okay. First of all, good evening, Toastmasters of the day, fellow Toastmasters and guests. If I had to teach something, then I'll teach some funny thing or some humorous thing, because why so serious every time? See, this is the time of coronavirus, and everybody has serious on this topic, but take care of ourselves and proper self. Hello. Proper care of ourselves, so no need to much worry about it. So why need to teach is serious. Don't be so serious for everything. Just care for. I'll teach this first lesson. First thing, if I had to teach anything, and then second one is how. That you don't like with live without with them, so I will teach second lesson if I had to. Thank you.
Thanks, Neha. Okay. So next, for the next topic, I would like to call Toastmaster Vatsal. Toastmaster Vatsal, can you hear me?
Yep.
Yeah. Okay. Toastmaster Vatsal, great minds think alike. Great minds think alike. Toastmaster Vatsal.
That's a pretty interesting topic. Great minds think alike. Any of us who actually have some ideas or some thoughts whenever we actually want to express something or have any sort of an innovation, or maybe even if it's just helping someone else. So all of us have one commonality, amongst us, to bring out the flamboyant side of us. And it doesn't really keep our hands tied down, because we have an open-minded side. And we actually tend to think in a very common way. Great minds are thinking alike in the sense that we like to be broad. We like to be open. We like to share our curiosity. And apart from that, we even, we won't have ego clashes. And actually, problem solving skills actually even comes into view when that happens. So be it, in any situation in your office, or maybe in your corporate life, or in politics, or whatever it is. But if you actually can connect with someone when you have a great mind, you automatically come to know about how other people interact, how other people communicate, and how ideas spread. And it's not just about saying something new, it's about empathizing with someone in that sense. So great minds do think alike, but some people might even say that great minds could even not be alike. It's actually also a sort of a paradoxical situation. But you could say this is a pretty interesting statement, which people might have different perspectives on. But yeah, I mean, great minds do think alike in many ways, and that actually helps people to make a much better world and, make it survive and through tough times. That's what I would say on this statement. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Toastmaster Vatsal. Okay, so moving forward, I'll take another topic, and for that I'd like to call upon our guest Raj Jagtap. So do we have Raj Jagtap online?
Can you hear me? Yes, I am. Can you hear me?
So Raj, yeah. So Toastmaster Raj, silence convey more meaning than words. Silence convey more meaning than words. Toastmaster Raj.
Good evening, everyone. Toastmaster of the day and my fellow Toastmasters.
silence convey more meaning than words. This is the topic. As you know, like whenever we are confronted with a problem, the first thing is we get agitated. That is the normal reaction that is found among most of us. But understanding the problem, analyzing it, and keeping your calm and silence is generally a better solution in such situation. There are many times, like when you are, I know, just an example, even if you are driving and you are faced, you got into a traffic jam, the first thing would be, you know, you will get agitated and try to move your way, honk and all. But if you just cool down, think it logically, keep your silence, automatically you'll realize that, you know, the situation is not that bad. There are certain situations which can't be helped at all. And keeping your silence in such situations, it's probably a better idea. All the great main saints and all, like they are actually masters in that. And we have to learn from them how they keep their silence in such difficult situations. Thank you.
Thank you. I'll take another topic, and I would like to check on the timer, but I would like to take one more topic right now. So Toastmaster Rutuja, are you online and can you hear me?
Yeah, I'm there.
Okay. So Toastmaster Rutuja, dreams of future are better than history of past. Dreams of future are better than history of past. Toastmaster Rutuja.
Okay. So dreams of future are better than history of past. Like, as we know that dreams are something you always want to achieve in life. So you must always try to keep and go forward. Whatever happened in the past was your past. And there were many examples, though the good ones, which help you to achieve good things in future. So do not underestimate those. But then ultimately, you have to focus on what you have to do in future. Whatever happened should be an example. It should not be something which will depress you, right? It should be something that will encourage you. Even if it is a bad incident, it's supposed to be a learning incident for you. So dreams of future, I think that if you dream for good things, you should learn, you will learn from your past, whatever it is, good or bad. So always try to keep learning, and whatever dreams are something you always want to achieve, right? It is something what you crave for. So always keep working towards it. Try to practice. And I think that will always help. That has been helping me for now. So I'm happy that whatever mistakes I've made in past, I made those. I learned from those. And now I'll be doing better in future. Thank you.
Thank you, Rutuja. I think I'm done with the topics. I'll take the report card. So timer, if you can help me to put the timings for the all table topic speaker. Farizat?
Good evening, everyone. All the speakers have qualified.
Okay.
So, okay. I can just give the times quickly. Anushka is 2 minutes, 8 seconds. Weber, 1 minute, 20 seconds. Neha, 1 minute, 18 seconds. Vatsal, 1 minute, 55 seconds. Raj, 1 minute 42 seconds, and Rutuja, 1 minute 18 seconds. Over to you.
Okay. So quickly on the voting for the best table topic speaker. So you can send your votes to our
Hold on. We know, yeah. Santosh, you might be having the Google form link. So Santosh will share the Google form link on the chat here itself. And people can open that link and vote in for the best table topic speaker.
Okay. All right. Thanks, Tanisha. Okay, so I'm done with the table topic session. Over to you, Toastmaster of the day, Tanisha.
Thank you, Vinod. Santosh, you are sharing the Google Form link. Okay, so we have this link. I request everyone to open and vote for the best table topic speaker.
I'm up.
Okay, thank you, Parijat. So before moving on to next section, as I have introduced you all with the top 7 leaders of our District 98, so here I am back again with my quiz. So you can type in your answers and send in private chat to 18 Toastmasters Club. And the question is, you have to write names of our top 3 district officers. The names of top 3 district officers. Now it is the time for the evaluations. So our general evaluator was facing some mic and audio issues. So by the time he joins in, I would like every one of you to unmute yourself. And since it is a Toastmaster themed meeting, and you all remember when we join Toastmaster during our induction, we get a Toastmaster membership card, which has a Toastmaster promise. So I request every one of you to unmute yourselves and then repeat the Toastmaster promise after me. And then I will, okay, so is everyone unmuted? I can see
yes.
People are not, okay. So repeat the Toastmaster promise with me. As a member of Toastmasters International.
As a member of Toastmasters International.
And my club.
And my club.
And my club.
I promise to attend club meetings regularly.
Promise to attend meetings regularly.
Prepare all of my projects to the best.
Prepare all of my projects to the best.
To the best.
Of my ability.
Of my ability.
Ability. My ability.
Basing them on the Toastmasters education program.
Basing them on the
Toastmasters education program.
To prepare for and fulfill meeting assignments.
Provide fellow members with helpful constructive evaluations.
To help the club maintain the positive.
Help club maintain the positive.
Maintain the positive.
Friendly environment.
Friendly environment.
Necessary for all members.
Necessary for all members.
Learn and grow.
Learn and grow.
To serve my club as an officer.
Serve my club as an officer.
When called upon to do so.
When called upon to do so.
To treat my fellow club members.
To teach my fellow club members.
And guests with respect and courtesy.
Bring guests to the club meeting.
So they can see the benefit of Toastmaster membership.
So that he can see the benefit of
Toastmasters.
To adhere to the guidelines and rules. For all Toastmasters educational and recognition programs.
For all Toastmasters recognition and recognition programs.
To act within Toastmasters core values. Of integrity, respect.
Of integrity and respect.
Service and excellence.
Service and excellence.
During the conduct of all Toastmaster activities.
During the conduct of all Toastmasters activities.
Thank you so much to repeat after me, and I'm sure that this is a great help to recall you all that why we all joined Toastmasters. And now we would be attending the meetings more regularly, taking up roles and taking up role even in the XCOM coming from the next term. So I can see.
Anisha, sorry, I'm interrupting you right here. I think we missed out one TT speaker's name during the voting. Is that right?
Yeah.
Yes.
Okay. I suggest we go for unfair. What we do is just allow me one moment. I'm deleting the previous responses. And in just one moment. So I think Rituja's name was missed out. Is that correct?
Yeah. Yes.
Okay, just a moment. We'll do that. Let's fix this. All right. The link remains the same. I request all of you to please vote again. Apologies for the inconvenience. Let us all vote again. The link remains the same. The link that Santosh has shared on the Zoom chat. Please use the link to vote for one of the table topic speakers.
In that only or?
Yeah, same
link. The same link.
Okay.
Hello, can everybody hear me? Hello?
Yes, sir.
Only 6 people have voted so far. 7.
We are around 20. I request everyone to vote.
We all have voting rights. Let's please vote for the best table topic speaker. Only 8 yet. Twelve. Interesting. 14. Great. Few more to go.
So yeah, you have to still count the votes, Sanjay, or we can start with our next section as we have our...
You can go ahead. I'll keep doing the counting. You can go ahead. Thank you.
So Nisarg, you are able to hear us?
Yes.
Okay. So now we will be starting with the evaluations. So today's general evaluator is a student who is studying computer and electronics, and he finds himself very energetic whenever he joins a Toastmaster meeting, be it online or offline. And I would say he is one of the active Toastmasters in taking up roles and giving speeches. So let's welcome Toastmaster Nisarg Mehta to take us through the evaluation section today.
Good evening, all.
Good evening.
On this speech, this session has been divided into 3 parts. First is the evaluation by the speaker on the speeches. Evaluator, please state a note that you will evaluate the speech and not the speaker. Second session would be the report given by the role player, that is the language evaluator report and the counter report. And the third is the report given by the general evaluator, that is me. So let's start with the first session. So we have someone who is a very recently joined Toastmasters and very energetic Toastmasters. She is an accidental software engineer and loves reading and trying out new things and talking about them. So let's welcome Toastmaster Nancy, who will evaluate Toastmaster Jitin's speech.
So good evening, one and all. I am Nancy Jain, and I'm evaluating the Toastmaster Jitin's speech. A great speech has good start, good body, and good conclusion. And congratulations, Toastmaster Jitin. Your speech qualified for that. And there are no office hours for leaders. And Toastmaster Jitin introduced such leader in his speech, like in this crucial situation like corona outbreak, and his sister is working for us. So he set an example for. So his sister set an example for that. We all were very attached to our parents from the very beginning, and he caught my attention as he was introducing his parents in his speech, and I think parents are a great leader, and then next he gave example of the current coronavirus situation and example of his sister, and then I have some recommendation for his speech, like language clarity. There were some mispronounced words he spoke during his speech. Some words noted, I guess he said that noted. So I think more language evaluator will say. And I think you should use hand gestures as well, like by standing little far from mic and use your hands. And then I was very impressed with the speech. Like, it has great good start, and you were very confident in your speech, and you started with great energy. You have good voice tonality, and you were stretching words whenever possible. Throughout his speech, you were very confident and energetic. You have a smile on. You have smile in your face that I liked as well, and that's all.
Thank you, Toastmaster Nancy, for the evaluation. Next, we have someone who is always been forward to help the Toastmasters in any of the situation and is a very motivating person. He works with Mahindra and Mahindra in sales department. His hobbies are tied in talking and networking. The one thing that he talks about Toastmaster is that the ease with which we connect the people across the globe. So let me welcome Toastmaster Sanjay, who will narrate Toastmaster Ravi's speech.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Nisarg, for that wonderful introduction. Before I begin my evaluation, can we have a round of applause, maybe a virtual Thank you. Toastmaster Ravi, the abstract concept or the abstract speech, what a fantastic topic you had chosen, the overturned window. I'm going to break my evaluation into three parts. Firstly, we can discuss about what I loved, what were the aspects that I loved in your speech. Second part, about what are certain things that could be improved. And third being an overall outlook. Now, one amazing thing that you had in your speech was an uncomfortable start. Yes, you heard it right. I'm calling it an uncomfortable start because you asked us two questions that made us a little uncomfortable. And as expected, as you had planned, no one went ahead and raised their hand. The first question was how many of you believe that in the next 2 years that was related to Pakistan, and the second one was related to Hinduism. However, you grabbed everyone's attention and then turned it around by mentioning that, don't you worry, this has got nothing to do with politics. So great job done. The second commendation that I have for you is with regards to your voice modulation. At a lot of points, you had stressed at the words where it was important and you had varied your voice accordingly. One example for that would be whenever you were going to use the words unthinkable, unimaginable, you did have the right kind of voice modulation that was required right there. And the third thing that I loved about your speech was how you decided to pick such a topic. Now, the whole idea of your speech, of the abstract speech in the Speaking to Inform manual, is to pick up something that is extremely complex and break it down very simply. You did choose the overturned window, a concept not many of us would have heard. But the way you simplified, the way you drafted your speech, and how well you connected it with all of us by giving relevant examples. So that is a great job done. Moving on to the recommendations, the first one would be, I felt you had more than three stories in your body. Now, it's not a mandate to have only three stories, but given that your topic is already a little complicated and you have to break it down simply, you might have cut down on certain stories, which would have eventually helped you finish well within time as well. Now, the time is not the recommendation here, but the recommendation is probably to reduce the number of stories, the number of examples you had. The second recommendation that I have for you is how you transitioned into the conclusion and how you really concluded. You did say that in conclusion, these are the points that I want to mention. However, I felt that at a point you had concluded, but then you went back and said 3 days back, this was another thing. So had you cut down a little on your conclusion, it would have helped people remember your idea really well. Having said that, no doubt you did present a new concept to all of us. I think all of us are going to try this technique of the overturn window by pitching something to the extremes, and we are sure that the other party is going to agree. So great job done with these recommendations and recommendations. I'm sure you'll do great. All the best and thank you so much. Thank you. Over to the general evaluator.
Thank you, Toastmaster Sanjay. Timer, can we have the timer report? Toastmaster Parijat.
Yeah, hi, good evening, everyone. So there were two evaluators, Toastmaster Nancy. Her time was 1 minute 50 seconds, and Toastmaster Sanjay, the time was 3 minute 12 seconds. So only Toastmaster Sanjay qualifies.
Okay. So it's not required to pass the doodle sheet or. So next is the report by a counter. So she is the very motivating person, ever smiling, and she is also my mentor. So I request Toastmaster Ankita to give a counter report.
Thank you, Toastmaster Nisarg, for that lovely introduction. Okay. Quick report. I will talk about the use of the crutch words, filler phrases by the club as a whole. One thing I would want to highlight here is that the use of filler phrases as a whole, as a club and by most members, is very, very low. So that's a great thing. I think where we tend to often interrupt and not be flawless is the often use of crutch words like ar and om. So that's an overall observation that I had to make. Quickly looking at how the role players and speakers did. Santosh, the sergeant at arms, one A. Nishant, the presiding officer, one crutch word. Then we had Tanisha, because by virtue of taking more stage time, she had more than 5 filler words. And then we had Rutuja, the language evaluator. She had one crutch word and one filler word. We had the timer. He tried his best, but he still had one filler word. Then we had, the timer was Toastmaster Parijat, by the way. Then we have Toastmaster Nisar, who is the general evaluator. He happened to use 2 crutch words. Toastmaster Nancy, actually she used a couple of crutch words, actually more than 5 crutch words, and just want to highlight, you often use like, so while that's not a part of the filler words, but it is part of the filler words, so I just wanted to highlight that. Then we had Toastmaster Vinod, the table topic master, had more than 5 crutch words. Toastmaster Anusha had 1 crutch word. Vaibhav had 1 crutch word, 1 filler word. Toastmaster Neha, 1 crutch word. Vatsal had more than 5 use of crutch words. And you often use actually. Just wanted to highlight that as a filler word. Okay. Then we had guest Rajakta. He used a couple of crutch words, 3 crutch words and 1 filler word, 1 filler phrase. And yeah, so finally we have flawless speakers. The ones who are not called out are our flawless speakers. So that's Toastmaster Jitin, Toastmaster Ravi, and Toastmaster Sanjay. So congratulations to you guys. Well done. Thank you. Over to the general evaluator.
Thank you, Toastmaster Ankita, for the great report. Now we have a language evaluator report. So she's also recently joined Toastmasters and is also doing a fabulous job. So welcome Toastmaster Neha, who will give the language evaluator report.
I would like to correct it. It's Toastmaster Rutuja, actually.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah.
So there was a great use of English language in today's meeting. We have had lots of words. For example, Toastmaster Chitin, in his speech, he has used words, phrases like new captain on the board. He has, then again, we have words like interventions, revoked, infiltrating, aggravate, etc. These words were used. Other words like mediocre, paradoxical were also used. Again, word of the day. The usage of word of the day was also good in today's meeting. Toastmaster Ankita, Toastmaster Amit, Beena Ma'am, Toastmaster Nishan, Toastmaster Tanisha, and Toastmaster Vatsal all have used these words. The word flamboyant. Phrase of the day was used very less though. It was used by the president, Toastmaster Tanisha. And yeah, that's my report. Thank you.
Thank you, Toastmaster Rutuja. Now it's time for General Yalitar report. So coming to the Sergeant at Arms of the day, Toastmaster Santosh. He's a motivational, ever smiling, and his advice are very good for the speaker. So you gave us a warm welcome, positive and encouraging introduction. And one important thing that you started meeting, even the online meeting, something 5 minutes late, but it can be okay. You mentioned about the club mission, which is very important for the guest as well as for the Toastmaster. One thing which I like from this is that you mentioned about the theme. You also passed the voting form on time. So you did a great job on that. So one round of applause for Toastmaster Santosh. So coming to next is Toastmaster of the day, Toastmaster Tanisha. First of all, very unique theme and great theme, because we often cannot think that in Toastmaster Club, someone is taking the theme of Toastmasters. Your introduction and the explanation of theme was very fabulous. You also mentioned about the number of clubs in Pune and number of people who have joined the Toastmasters Club in Pune, that is around 16,000 people. Agenda, which was also sent on WhatsApp group on time. And you engaged the audience by asking questions and explaining some of the terms in Toastmasters, which is very important, and many of us does not know the terms in Toastmasters. One suggestion for Toastmaster of the day is that this is not particularly for Toastmaster Tanisha, but who will be in the future TMOD also. Please ensure that the agenda, the Google map location, which is the online map location, and the poster, which is made by VPPR, Toastmaster Parijat, is being sent on mail also, because many of people even though see the WhatsApp, but also see the mail. Otherwise, you did a fabulous job today. So I really loved the thing. Coming to the timer, Toastmaster Parijat, he is the multitasking Toastmaster who makes a fabulous poster for every meeting. You explained your role very clearly, and you also followed the rule which the timer has to do of green, red, and yellow, which will I was seeing that the many of the speakers were confident when they were speaking. And this is because you have chosen the topic which is very simple, and this could help the Toastmasters and guests to relate the topic what they are speaking. So I would like to congratulate that you have done a very fabulous job, because you are also a recent joining Toastmasters, and well done. Coming to the two evaluators who are evaluating the Toastmaster Jitin and Toastmaster Ravi speech,
Toastmaster Nancy and Toastmaster Sanjay, you followed the CRC approach. By recommendation, you push the speaker 100% and boost the confidence of the speaker. And by recommendation, you made the speaker good speech to great speech. And by recommendation, you made the speaker to give the best output in the future. So you both followed the CRC approach. Also, by adding the example, which is given by Toastmaster Sanjay, you actually helped the speaker to relate where he was going wrong. So you both did a fabulous job. And the last is the presiding address, Toastmaster Nishant. As always, it's a very great presiding officer address. So I really liked it, and you asked the guest about their introduction. So it was really great. So I think so. This all from my side, and I would like to thank all of you for this meeting. So over to Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you, Nisar, for taking us through the evaluation session today. It was really a detailed and a good evaluation session. So now we will go for the award, voting for the best role player of the day. So I would request our Sergeant at Arms, Toastmaster Santosh, to share the Google Form link on the chat with everyone. And we will vote for the best role player. So I'll call the role player's name again. So today's role players were Toastmaster Santosh, Toastmaster Parijat, Toastmaster Rutuja, Toastmaster Ankita, Toastmaster Nisar, Toastmaster Vinod, and Toastmaster Tanisha. So you can click on the link and vote for the best role player. So now, once the Best Role Player Award is being announced and the votes are being calculated, in the starting itself, I announced that there would be a different speech which would be given by Toastmaster Ankit. So this time, Toastmaster Ankit is going to present the Best Speaker Award, as it is one of the objectives of his speech. And after that, the presiding officer would take over for the moments of glory. So I would request Toastmaster Anil, who is Ankit's evaluator, to read out the objectives of the Toastmaster Ankit's speech.
Thank you. So this is presenting an award, Project 4. The purpose of this project is for the speaker to present an award with dignity, grace, and sincerity. The presentation speech should be 3 to 4 minutes in length. So it's 3, 3.5, 4. The speaker will explain the purpose of an award and why the recipient deserves it. All right, good luck, Toastmaster Ankit.
Thank you, Toastmaster Anil. So timer, please note, the time allotted is 3 to 4 minutes. So the lightning sequence would be green at 3 minutes, yellow at 3 minutes, 30 seconds, red at 4 minutes, and the buzzer needs to be shown at 4 minutes, 30 seconds. So the speaker is someone who is a tech savvy. He has been a Toastmaster since 7 years now, and now Toastmaster is his family. So let us welcome the area director, Toastmaster Ankit.
Thank you, Toastmaster Tanisha. Toastmasters, I will go ahead and read the tagline for Toastmasters: where leaders are made. Fellow Toastmasters, we all come to a Toastmasters meeting to learn and to improve ourselves. We study our projects from a manual of a path and then try to do justice with completing all the objectives in that speech, in that project, included in our speech. A speaker takes effort, planning, and works on his delivery. To appreciate the hard work put in by the speaker, Toastmasters International has a concept of acknowledging and the speaker. The flamboyant speaker of the day is someone who receives the award of the best speaker of the day. The members of the meeting who are present there decide and vote and select for the best speaker. Today, this award of the best speaker is going to be awarded to Toastmaster Jitin. Jitin, your speech had most of the ingredients of an amazing speech, showcasing the live examples of situational leadership. You talked about how your mother took up the reins of the family. You also talked about and shared an instance where Indira Nui was taught the leadership, taught some lessons despite her being selected as the head of a national bank. You also ended with sharing that fact that your sister, who is in London, is traveling 3 hours in a train to serve the public, who is a nurse, as a nurse. Now, all these instances evidently imprinted the leadership traits within you and your role models subconsciously over the period of time and over the period of years imparted those knowledge within you. These beautifully captured objectives of your speech, which even your evaluator, Toastmaster Nancy, resonated with. Your speech had a proper IBC, introduction, body, and conclusion. You also did not talk in a blue streak, and each of your words was heard clearly to all and each and every one of you. Overall, I would say, Toastmaster Jitin, you are a Toastmaster in the making. You are a Toastmaster who is on the way to become a leader. Hence, to speak on the situation leadership in an organization where the tagline is where leaders are made is the very right way, Toastmaster Jitin, to have achieved this Best Speaker Award. I would like to virtually hand you over the Best Speaker Certificate, which can be passed on by Toastmaster Parijat. But as a token of appreciation, I would like to award you this Toastmasters emblem paperweight as the Best Speaker Award. I request you to please accept it as the Best Speaker of the day. Thank you, Jitin. And with this, I hand over the stage back to, or the control back to, the presiding officer, Toastmaster Nishant.
Thank you so much, Ankit.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Ankit. That was an amazing speech. Thank you. Today we had an amazing meeting. I mean, we all of us used to think Toastmasters is just a platform. But today, a lot of speakers told us it's not just a platform. It's a forum for sharing ideas. It's more like a family where people help each other evolve. Toastmaster Tanisha rightly said, it's a family. Yes, all of us here help each other out and improve together as a group and not just individually. That is something commendable I love about Toastmasters. The world thinks it's just a platform where you give toast, but no, it's more than that. And that was something that was exhibited by each and every participant in this meeting. Well done. I think it's now time for moments of glory. Let us go towards it. First would be the best table topic speaker. Anyone wants to take a guess who would it be? Anyone can take a guess?
Anushka.
Okay, so it's a tie between Toastmaster Vatsal and Toastmaster Anushka for the best table topic speaker.
Damn, thank you. Yes. Congrats to Toastmaster Anushka.
Now, next is for the best evaluator. And it goes to Toastmaster Sanjay. And finally, it's time for the best role player of the meeting who contributed immensely towards the meeting. And it is none other than Toastmaster Tanisha as for her TMOD role. Today, all of us witnessed another online meeting. So I would like to take guest feedback for how was your experience. Toastmaster Ravi Sharma, can you please share your experience of Bane Toastmasters online meeting?
Sure. Thank you so much. This is my second meeting I'm attending at Bane Toastmasters. I think the first meeting which we had on 14th of March, if I'm not wrong, that was the first online meeting which District 98 had. And I was glad to be a part of that a little bit for 10 minutes. So that very time I told Tanisha, I'm going to come to the next meeting. I'm taking a speech slot. And I feel it's my privilege the way the session has gone so seamlessly. The Robin, that round was also very nice, interesting round. I think I could participate in that. But I think that momentum is now getting built up in the entire district that we need to come up with online meetings. And the meetings cannot stop for all of us because everyone wants to keep going. So thank you so much. I enjoyed the meeting and I would request the club to keep on having the meeting every time, every week as you plan. And let's grow together and let's embrace the change that is there in front of all of us. Thank you.
Next, Toastmaster Anushka, how was your experience of Bane Toastmasters online meeting?
Hello everyone. First of all, thank you so much for voting for me and Vatsal as well. We both have won the table topics. Thanks a lot for that. And the experience, I do feel that Bane Toastmasters has one of the most amazing speeches. So I was extremely excited. Amazing speeches as well as amazing table topics, the questions. So I was really excited for this one. And honestly, you guys did not disappoint. The feedbacks were amazing. Toastmaster Sanjay, he always does this seamless, effortless job. I don't know how he does that, but I really look up to that. And to every single one, especially the TMOD, she was so flawless. I really loved the energy that was put into it and every single role player as well. I wish Bane Toastmasters all the very best and I'm looking forward to attend much more meetings. Thank you.
Bina ma'am, how was your experience for the online meeting?
Attending Bane Toastmasters meeting is like coming home, of course, because I've been a part and parcel of this club right from its inception. So it was nothing new. In fact, I love to attend Toastmasters meeting. It's a day prior to ours. And all the lessons learned from Bane Toastmasters meeting, I can incorporate. In 3 to 5 tomorrow, we're having ours. So, excellent, excellent meeting, wonderfully conducted, seamless, as they said. I enjoyed myself. And do attend ours tomorrow between 3 and 5. We will send the link to you. Thank you.
Definitely. Thank you.
I was coming back home, frankly speaking. And ever since I came here, I have been actually offline from Toastmasters for almost, I think, 6 to 7 months. And communication goes on every single day. And I think if not for Toastmasters, I would have had a very different life here. Speaking to people over here, how to speak, how to talk, and communicating with people of different languages. So Toastmasters doesn't just teach you English, it teaches you to express. It teaches you to be free and confident. And it's been many years in over here, and I just feel refreshed and I feel back home. That's all I can say. So good to see all of you guys. Thank you so much for this. Thank you so much.
Yes, and finally, Toastmaster Ankit, how was your experience for Bane Toastmasters online meeting?
Nishant, it was amazing.
I whenever I come and visit Barnett Toastmasters Club, the warmth which I get from all the members is amazing. And to witness the club doing its third online meeting so seamlessly is just praiseworthy. So kudos to you and the entire set of role players and the executive committee to come up with this meeting online and successfully conducting it.
Thank you.
Over to you.
Thank you. So if we have any guests here, please get in touch with Toastmaster Santosh. He is the VP membership for our club. He'll guide you about the membership process. So do get in touch. And yes, Toastmaster Vatsal, yeah.
I just have one final thing to just say is that yes. I am just so glad that I did not take admission in the US or in these places, because there are too many Indians there once more. Coming over here has forced me to diversify. That is one of the biggest applications of this club, which I have been through. So just want to say this. That's all. Thank you so much.
Thank you so much. Thank you. Yes. And now finally, it will be one of our group selfies, which will be definitely virtual. So I would request everyone to just turn on your webcams for a group photograph. Yes. Toastmaster Parijat, are we capturing it?
Since it's a Toastmaster theme meeting, I request everyone to show a tea.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Okay, I'm capturing it.
Yes.
There we go.
Yes.
Done.
Thank you.
And now we can adjourn the meeting and we can now have fellowship online if that's there. Toastmaster Sanjay can guide us over the fellowship.
My God, come on, Nishant, why me?
Yes.
Fantastic, nice meeting.
Yes.
Good. Yes. How's everyone doing day 3, day 4 of the lockdown?
I started.
Very boring, very, very boring.
All right, very boring. Tell us something new.
Sanjay, it's raining outside. Sanjay, it's raining heavily outside.
The awesome is amazing outside.
Oh wow! I mean, it's nothing new for the place that I am in. It is raining every day here. It's raining in Pune, seriously?
Yeah.
It's showers.
It's
been for last 3 days.
It's going to rain only. I'm just eagerly waiting when it's going to start.
Yes.
All right. You know, I think you were saying something.
Where are you? If not in Pune, where are you?
I'm not in Pune. I've come home.
Okay. Okay.
Yeah.
He ran away early.
Yeah, yeah. A trip.
Sanjay, you went OT before the lockdown?
Yeah. Yes. Last Thursday.
He just managed to speak out.
Just in time.
Yes.
Last week. Yes.
Technically, so basically, he broke the rule of lockdown.
Last Thursday.
10 days ago.
10 days ago, exactly.
Yes, Toastmaster Vatsal, how's life there?
Life here, my goodness. I miss India, to be very honest. Though now it's a ghost town back home, but over here, people just play games and stuff and keeping social distancing into account, definitely. And people over here don't do this a lot now when they actually meet up. So namaste has become a sort of a norm here now, very interestingly. And people over here, they are very cautious about things, definitely. Too cautious. Yeah, and over here, people are already quite less on the streets, to be honest. And now I would say there's not too much of a difference. But people over here, they have gone back home since they are from the countries over here itself. So, yeah, I mean, like, sometimes I feel I want to just take a flight back home. But I'm like, no, it's 13 hours and I have to, you know, once I come, I want to spend a good month back home. A good damn month.
And budget bhi dekhna hota hai.
And abhi we are not allowing anyone
to come. I'm Gujarati, you to speak.
That's true. Oh my god.
Is there a power cut, Jitin?
Everyone is having that issue.
There was a power cut here also.
Yeah. I'm capturing some amazing screenshots. One of Ankita, now it's time for Jitin.
Ankita, I have also captured one of Ankita.
I'm unable to see him at all, yaar.
Vatsal would be like, kaha ye log power cut ki baat kar rahe
hain. Vatsal, we live in India.
First world problems.
Chote log, choti shehar, choti baatein.
Oh my God. Chalo guys, believe it or not, to just in, I mean, just in the morning, we had a power cut for 1 hour.
Yeah. Oh.
Just to, year, just year mein ek hi baar hota hai wo power cut.
Like a yearly power cut, a quarterly power cut.
I know. Yes. Wo to hai. Oh my
All God. Of you stay safe, stay home. We have yes. 4 weeks yes. to kill. I mean, 2 more weeks, 2.5 weeks to kill.
Yep.
God knows yeah. after that if it gets extended.
It's going the thing.
Why Tanisha? Why? Let's avoid that.
You know what? This is my 17th day at my home and I have not went out. I got work from home since 11th. And I am like literally bored. Like I'm
fat already, Tanisha. You're looking fat on screen.
That is my dress. Oh, my God. Oh, my God. The way I was eating. Like I know ho jaye to achhi baat hai. But वो नहीं होगा। सी वत्सल कह रहा है क्या बात करते हो संजय तो।
हाँ यार क्यों ये फेलोशिप में बैठा हूँ यार क्यों क्यों?
वो नेक्स्ट टाइम आया था भी नहीं।
को बुलाया है गवर्नमेंट ने।
No it's 3 straight weeks. No Durga कैपे मसाला पाव no Durga कैपे।
संजय is missing मसाला पाव with that onion.
Yeah even I'm missing.
Yeah.
And Toastmaster Vatsal सोच रही है क्या इंडियन खाने की बात कर रहे हैं मैं तो अभी यूरोपियन हो गया
कहाँ तो मैं क्रोसॉन और बेगल खाता हूँ
he just shared a different opinion with me
मैं बना नहीं हूँ by the way just to inform you guys I mean even though I'm not I have learned to cook within 6 months by the way मजबूरी के अंदर प्रेशर के अंदर सब कुछ हो जाता है व्हेन यू हैव टू गेट अप एंड गो इन द किचन एस्पेशली व्हेन देयर आर सो मेनी पीपल आवर किचन इट्स सॉर्ट ऑफ शेयरिंग विद 12 अदर पीपल थैंकफुली वी हैव टू कुक ओनली इन द प्रेजेंस ऑफ 4 or 5 ओवर हियर आई हैव बीन कुकिंग फूड एंड दीस पीपल आर आस्किंग अस फॉर आवर रेसिपीज नाउ turmeric with water or milk and stuff like that, dal and stuff. These people follow our, ways of eating, like, I mean, here. And now my friends come with me to the Indian stores to eat our food, believe it or not. Literally.
Proud Indian. मेरे को proud uncle feeling आ रहा है ऐसा कि बच्चा बड़ा हो गया हल्दी दूध की बातें कर रहा
है. Don't forget one very important thing called chyawanprash, by the way.
Necessity is the mother of invention. I hope you are inventing a lot of dishes over there also.
When my mom used to give me a call to ask, she only asked one thing. Tu zinda hai na? Bas. That's all. Oh my God.
All right, chalo guys, I'll take leave. See you all. Bye. Great catching up.
Yeah.
See you guys. Bye bye. Thank you for nice catching up. Good to see you, Vatsal. Bye bye. Take care. Stay home and safe. Yeah, everyone stay at home. Yeah, stay home. This is the only way to save. To keep safe. Yes, yes. Stay at home. Bye bye. Take care. Bye bye. Jai Hind. See you. Jai Hind. Jai Bharat. That's what happens when you miss India too much.
Jai Hind, Jai Bharat.
Itna to hum bhi nahi karte. Chalo, bye.
Arey, Amit is not. Sanjay, tumhe kuch bolna tha?
Arey, haan. Nishant, yaar, wo ye karwa do yaar. Pathways
wala. Haan, maine Abhishek se baat kiya. Abhishek bola, main shaam ko kar raha hu.
Kal Suraj ka. Let's close, please.
Haan, haan. Suraj ka to phone hi nahi lag raha hai. Message, phone, kuch nahi hai uska.
All right.
Let's see. Subodh ka ho gaya. Subodh ka ho gaya.
Okay. All right. Talk to you guys soon. Take care, Vatsal. Yep.
Bye bye. Take care, Vatsal bhaiya. Miss karenge.
Bye, Vatsal bhaiya.
Eiffel Tower. Bye, Tanisha. Whatever.
Yes, thank you. Thank you for calling me.
Just a new name. अरे तनिषा दादी इज हर न्यू नेम.
ए हटो.
ओह गॉड.
ये सबको पता है. ये दीदी
स्टार्टेड अगेन विद ऑल यू कैन इग्नोर.
आई हैवंट इग्नोर्ड इट. डोंट मेक मी.
दादी बन गई है तनिषा भी.
यू थिंक सो? तुम संजय के एक सेकंड तुम संजय की बातों पे विश्वास करोगे वत्सल? लाइक सीरियसली
तनिषा योर वॉइस इज लैगिंग लाइक सुपर अमेजिंग.
दादी मां आपकी आवाज नहीं आ रही है.
Exactly. Bad network, bad electricity. Like I feel like I'm living in a village right now. एक सेकंड एक चीज बताना संजय. अरे ये रिकॉर्डिंग सेव करना होता है कि सेव हो जाता है?
सेव हो जाता है देखो.
कहाँ सेव होता है वो देखना पड़ेगा फिर.
सेव इन द फोल्डर मतलब सी यूजर्स जूम वहीं पे गई.